Hallelujah, glory. Okay, I'm not on CBS Survivor Amazon anymore. I'm at WATC 57 in Norcross. You're on the move with yours truly, JoAnna Ward, CBS Survivor contestant that still stands out and saying, hallelujah. And thank you, Jesus. Do it, Jesus. That's my Jesus. So thank you guys for joining us. I hope that you are ready to get moving. I hope that you are excited about exercising. Today, I have two guests with me, Nancy Ward and Shyandra Colson. Thank you for joining. Thank you for joining, and thank you for joining. We are going to do some super exercises with the chair or your couch or your counter or anything that kind of has a seated thing for you, okay? Like this yonda. But we're gonna warm up first, so you guys go ahead and stand up or you can stay seated. I want you to move, just move, just move. We're gonna start here with the side to the right. Ten, nine, 11, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, last left. Yeah, we're gonna keep this for 10 more. Nine, eight, seven, six, five to right. Four, three, two, go right, go right. 10, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, last right, left. 10, nine, eight, seven, six, five to alternate. Four, three, two, and one.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. Guess what?
Hold up. Why?
God's got it.
God's got it.
God's got it.
God's got it.
God's got it. I hope you're moving with me.
God's got it.
All right, we're going to tap back.
I look around and my heart is a little heavy. The money's fading fast and I'm looking for a blessing.
Yep.
People looking for jobs, no one looking for God. I know that you heard, but in time God is really going to work.
Oh. We're just warming up. No big deal. Just moving our bodies in a way that we don't typically do in the day. Okay, we're gonna push out. And we're gonna breathe. I'm not gonna worry about it. Yeah, yeah. It is what it is. And we're gonna push this down on three, two, one. Oh, got that right. Yeah, yeah. He got it. Hallelujah. Woo! And we're gonna double it up on four, three, two. Last single double. Double. God's got it. Trust him. Don't trust me. About it. Four more doubles. Three, two to singles. Last double, single, single. Don't worry about it. Guess what? God's got it. God's got it. God's got it. God's got it. March it out here. Good job. Circle it up. Hallelujah. Take it back up. And here. And here. We're going to stretch our arms out. Take it around. Left goes to right. And we're going to switch it up. Good job. We're gonna come here with our palms on our chair or your couch or your counter. And we're just gonna do little small hops. Now, if you can't do hops, just bounce. And the thing about it is you can do these like anywhere at any time before you go to bed, as soon as you wake up. You don't have to get up and go to the gym. That'll be great, but if you can, you know what? I'm gonna do a song
and I'm gonna grab onto the edge of the bed or the couch or the counter or the dresser or whatever, and I'm just gonna hop. Now, why is this important and effective? I'll tell you why. Because if I do this, say what you guys are, it's putting all that weight on my knees and ankles and back. Whereas I lean forward, not only am I getting toning on top, but I'm also taking the pressure off of my knees and back, okay? We're gonna do two more of these. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. You're gonna come up and get a deep breath. I am drenched again. You guys are still dry. How is that possible? I know. My body needs to cool down. Okay, so we're gonna go back into that position. I wanna give you guys your arms a break. We're gonna go back into this position. And now we're gonna do what we call a flat jack, except for we're using our chairs. And it's gonna go just like this, okay? Just like this. And of course, the further you are back, the more you're gonna get those abs, arms, chest, pecs, and shoulders involved, okay? If that's too much, you come up, take that weight back off of the arms, put it back onto the legs, and still support yourself. But again, if you wanna get more intense, you're gonna drop that body flat. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and let's come up. Give those arms a break. How you guys feel? Why am I the only one sweating? Is it just what I do? I know why I'm sweating. And I like sweating. Sweating purges your bodies of all kinds of carcinogens. And like I tell people, you can wipe and wash sweat off, but fat, not so easy. And we're gonna come here and take a deep breath. And you're still leaning. We're gonna just switch up here. Now, why am I able to do this? Because most of my weight is here on the chair. I'm just gonna skip, skip. Okay, good job. And so I'm taking all the pressure off of my knees and using my arms, stabilizing. Perfect, breathe. Five, four, three, two, last one. Awesome. So that was a big ballistic, but when you use a chair or use what I call a stabilizing device, it takes all of the pressure and impact off and still gives you the same intensity. How's that? Was it okay? You felt it? Okay. So now we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna shorten up our stride and chop a little bit shorter. So go back to our stabilizing device. Couch, counter, or whatever you're using, chair preferably. And it's a small chop. How you guys doing at home? You're like, I can't breathe. Don't talk to me, it's over. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Ah! How you guys feel? Still not sweating yet? Just a little bit. Good job. I'm gonna take the chair and turn it around. I know you gotta like thank God for Jesus. Our show is only about 15 minutes as far as the fitness segment. So I want you guys to know that you literally can take that 15 minutes and do fitness and faith, kind of combination of two. You get your worship music on like you hear playing it back and get your word open, do your workout, and your worries will be fewer. Our next exercise is gonna be for this little roll. This little roll of mine, I'm gonna let it find. This little roll of mine, I'm gonna decline. This little roll of mine, I'm gonna decline, decline. Which of y'all gonna decline y'all too? You should decline your little roll. Don't even claim it. But this is to work his here. So you notice I have two weights, so this is 10 pounds. You can definitely use one or none. We're gonna start with these 10 pound weights. You wanna kinda slide in your chair and slouch like you were taught not to do, because this is not about posture, this is about a position for exercise. And we're gonna just come here and tap and lift. So it's for that little push that's no longer yours. And you're breathing. And you're smiling. And you're happy about it. Because this is better than getting cut and get surgery and all that other kind of stuff. It's so simple. It takes such small little things to do every single day that makes a big difference by laying your foundation of faith and fitness first. That's why in Matthew 6 it says, seek the kingdom of God first and his righteousness. And so many people seem to have so much energy and time to do everything but seek the kingdom of God. And I like the fact that in Matthew it says seek. Here I am talking again and not counting. We're gonna pause. It says seek because you have to be engaged. Anything you try to do, you don't just automatically know it. You gotta put time in, energy, and research. And too many of us are not paying attention to what God has to say about us, life, struggles, and issues. So we're gonna do the same thing, but it's a little bit more, long as opposed to fast and quick. So it's gonna go here, and we're gonna stretch it out. Hey! One of my favorites. Hey! As I look back over my life, I can see how your love has guided me, even though I know y'all was perfect, but I've done some wrong things. He never left me alone. Five more. Every morning, great is thy faithfulness. Two more. Hey. All right. See? So if you did those with us, that's why you had that push. Because you don't work that area of your life. And a lot of people struggle with faith because they don't work with that area of their lives. We're gonna turn here. But we're gonna talk about that when we come back. I can see how the love is guiding me. And let's switch. Even though I've done wrong, you never left me alone. But you forgave me. You kept on. We're gonna come up here. Therefore, I have hope. We're rotating our ankle. That we are not consumed. Now, you can do one leg at a time as well. If you can't do both, because he shares with you, you can do one leg at a time. By faithfulness. And we're gonna turn here and lean forward. Put that left arm over. And let's switch it up. You guys have been awesome. Bam, bam. Thank you, ma'ams. So yes, we're gonna talk about what this means, Christ alone. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Even you, even you, even you, you and me too. You guys, go and get your pen and paper. You don't wanna miss this message. We'll be right back after this break. We're not working out anymore. Just kidding. Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Thank you guys so much for working out with us and waiting for us to come back. I hope you enjoyed the break. We are back with Danielle Clark from Worship Center of Atlanta Church, and she is outstanding. Welcome, welcome, welcome to On the Move, Danielle. Thank you so much for joining us through Zoom.
Thank you so much. So glad to be here.
So I'm not going to just start off with the beautiful voice that you have as a praise and worship leader. I want to start off with a little bit more about you as a person, the roles that you play in your day-to-day life, and why you love the Lord.
Why I love the Lord, my reason is because he has done so much for me.
Yes.
I'm already getting a little emotional because it took me a while to get to where I am right now. Mm-hmm. Took a lot of growth. a lot of maturity. And I have honestly been through or been in some uncomfortable places to where I had to sit back and do nothing but trust God. So he has really come through for me, for my family. And I believe that placing me at Worship Center of Atlanta, where I serve as part of the praise team, that has had a huge impact on my faith and even my growth. I look at 2022 right now, it's my season of growth.
Amen. Amen. So tell us a little bit about yourself. We and I appreciate your testimony. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of our testimony. And so it's so important that people know that there are other people who have experienced and come over on the other side of through. I often, you know, try to tell people who are 20 years behind me, if you keep on living, you're going to come this way too. And there's a lot of things you can do to either make it hard or easy. So thank you for sharing that aspect of your testimony, because while the word of God is powerful and quicker than any two-edged sword, our testimonies in today, like you said about 2020, that is what takes people back to the feet of Christ through the convicting power of his blood.
Yes.
So thank you for that.
Yes.
So tell us about your business, Beautiful Coaching and Consulting Music.
Beautiful Music, Coaching and Development. I am a vocal trainer. So I actually have about 20 years of experience, close to it. I actually started in Detroit, Michigan. I was actually working with a company called Star Factory. That was actually my first position as a vocal trainer. Then I ended up moving here to Atlanta, a place that I love so much. and it was quite a few bumps in the road. Of course, life hits you. You got to make some sacrifices, but then I decided it was time for me to really get down to business like I should. So actually this year, I finally got my LLC for my business, so I'm official.
Great.
Thank God.
Great, great. Congratulations.
Yes, thank you so much. But of course, I do offer vocal training. Eventually, I'll be tapping into performance, stage presence, or you know, things of that nature, because at one point in my life, I was an artist. Most people still say that I am, but I just kind of feel like that God has taken me in a totally different direction. I mean, my pastor has even, you know, said to me that, you know, even though I love some secular music, I don't listen to all of it, but I do love my old school, but he did tell me that it wasn't where I was supposed to be. So I really had to tap in and say, okay, God, what do I do? And the answer that I got was to serve. So that's one of the reasons why I started my business back. And, you know, I'm excited about working with people. I'm still in the building process, but this point I'm trusting God. So I'm just really excited about it.
And it's an amazing crossover, and we're supposed to grow. People think it's just a straight path to in this faith, and it's really not. It's a process, and it takes patience and endurance. And so I'm glad you said that, because we do need to understand the impact of music on our souls. You know, a lot of people, it's just music. It's just lyrics. It's not really meaning anything. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing not only comes by the word of God, but whatever you hear. And so there are all kinds of ministers going out in music, you know, and it's not all holy. And some of it actually is unholy and depressive and causes all kinds of different things to come. So I'm glad you said that your pastor said that. And it's important that we do keep people in our lives that hold us accountable. And so thank you for taking those steps. And I tell people, as soon as you start walking, the steps will appear. A lot of people think that, no, God showed me the steps and then I'll start to stepping. But that's not how it works at all. Faith is about what you don't see. It's about things that you're hoping for. So as soon as you start moving in the direction that God tells us to move, you'll see those steps appear. So, Danielle, can you help somebody like me learn how to sing? And if you could, in about 2 minutes, could you take me through like a orientation, if that's at all possible?
Sure. When it comes down to vocal training, it's really the most important thing that I feel like a lot of people miss. Being in the music industry for a while as an artist, I've also been on the back end. So again, I see that there is lack of training. So when people come to me, they are really looking for a change, and they're also looking for growth. Mm-hmm. I won't necessarily say an orientation, but a session with me, it takes about an hour. Mm-hmm. And I really dig deep into how the voice works, the anatomy. You'd be surprised that a lot of people do not realize that it's so much going on in here that we have to rely on, and you also have to take care of it. A lot of people aren't taking care of it. So when you perform or you sing somewhere, you notice that a person's voice may get scratchy, or, you know, maybe they're not breathing in and out enough air. But again, what I go through is just the anatomy of the voice. We also talk about vocal health. We talk about vocal warm-ups. I also improvise with, breathing exercises. And I actually give homework.
Okay.
So I make people do their research, and I make them read articles. I'm all about information, because everything that I give you is going to help you be better at what you're doing. And surprisingly, not just singers, but rappers, hip hop artists, they need it as well. So, but that's pretty much what it is like within a session with me. And then of course, sessions after that, it just continues. Again, I'm all about growth. And I'm all about just making things better.
Awesome sauce. So in other words, I will be able to sing after a session. So you can help
absolutely.
Hallelujah.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, glory. Yes. I did that in the jungle. I did that in the jungle so much that everybody in production was like, don't worry about it, don't worry about it. It's just JoAnna screaming again. I was on Survivor, and so in order to get through the torment of being out there, I'll just break out. And before they did any interviews, I would just scream that hallelujah. And actually, I got the title Hallelujah Lady. So what do you think about that as far as the voice, as far as the training or whatever it is? I've been doing it for 20 years.
Well, first of all, you have a beautiful voice.
Thank you. You're so sweet.
Let me just say that. And honestly, all it really takes is vocal warm-ups and breathing. One of the suggestions that I actually usually give to all of my clients, using like a piano, matching your voice with those notes. Mm-hmm. And I mean, other than that, I mean, you'll be totally fine. I will have to say, not trying to toot my own horn, but I have literally had clients even in the past that has said, like, Danielle, I was very shocked at what I sounded like before I started and what I sound like after, because people don't realize those vocal warm-ups and those breathing exercises, it makes a complete total change really in a matter of seconds, but you also have to make it a habit.
Right. And I know what you're saying is true, because I don't sing, I'm not on anybody's choir, never have been. I'm a worshiper, raw worshiper, off the cuff, unplanned, unpredicted. And what people fail to realize, and I'm sharing this with my audience as well as with you, is that early in the morning, I get outside and I'll just sing. And I don't know if it's a warm up or what, but whenever I need to worship, it turns on automatically, and I believe that I've been inadvertently warming up with worship for decades now. I mean, it's literally part of my routine. It sets the atmosphere of my day, and it just changes things. Worship changes the environment, and I think people totally underestimate the power of worship. They are really looking for a sound, and God is looking for a worshiper. They're looking for, you know, a trained voice to hear, and that's fine in the industry for entertainment, but when it comes to moving and shifting things in the spiritual realm, worship throughout biblical experiences and throughout my lifetime has been the key. And with the 2 minutes we have left, including close, could you tell us a little bit or share a little bit with us about your role as a praise and worship leader, how God is using you now in that position?
Well, I'm actually not officially the praise and worship leader at my church, but I have been a part of the praise team for the last 6 years. Worship Center of Atlanta is a brand new church, and I was actually approached to fill in for somebody, for someone, 6 years ago to participate in this first service. At the time I was approached, I was going through church hurt. And so after that first service, I wasn't planning on going back to church because I'll be honest, I was in a place to where I felt like I was mad at God, that things were not going the way that they should have. But here I am 6 years later, still on the praise team. I would have to say this experience has been very eye-opening for me. Because I am also up under a prophetic ministry. So I have learned so much. And, you know, I really thank God for my pastor, who is Prophet Luther C. McKinstry. He has really been very instrumental in my life, even in my family's life, my husband and my children, and just always keeping an eye on us and making sure that we're good. But one thing for sure is I'm with you, and that praise and worship hits.
Yes.
It hits.
Amen.
And I mean, I go in, so I understand.
Well, thank you so much, Danielle, for joining us. And I thank God for your pastor, your passion for praise and worship. And I thank you guys for joining me on The Move with the Worship, the workout. And I pray that God continues to show you the way that He wants you to live for Him. You've been on The Move with JoAnna Ward and Danielle Clark. Thank you again. We'll see you guys next time.